the naked light I saw. 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs that voices never share. No one did disturb the sound of silence.
The meaning of any message is how it's perceived, not necessarily what was intended. I grew up in Atlanta in the Buckhead area, went to Emory, went to public school, I'm a product of the public school, and went to Emory University, and then went on, was fortunate enough to go to law school and graduate school, and get a lot of alphabet soup after my name. However, in that process, I did the real learning about life. And I realized, particularly in some of the higher credentialed areas, it was better to stay silent. And throughout, I kept wondering about silence. And what does it do to us when we stay silent in the face of not being rude, of speaking up for what's right? There was the Vietnam War. There were a number of elections, Republican, Democrat. There were economic ups and downs. And through that, I learned to the point that I knew that I wanted to do something to change policy. I didn't realize that when you become a public figure, everything's fair game.
Yeah.
People can say whatever they want, whether it's true or not. And I was shocked by that. And I remember thinking to myself, while I'm being attacked for something that wasn't true, where are the people who come forward and say, that's not true? Where's the civility in government? That year, I got to spend some time with Sandra Day O'Connor in Nashville. And she and I talked at length about things. And her greatest interest is civility and the sound of silence. The fact that as we live in uncivilized ways today, even from the nicest families, where is the voice that speaks out and says, this is wrong, this is incorrect, this is not okay? She, in fact, has a foundation now in Washington, teaching kids civility. Not that you agree, everybody agreeing is boring. It's that you learn how to have discourse and you learn how to disagree, and out of the disagreement comes something even better. We're sitting here with filters that have grown up with us for a very long time. And we all see things in many different ways. What I saw was a young man with an open hand reaching out. I see him saying, please don't be silent. Help. And I don't know what he wanted help with. I don't know. What I see with the lady is a lady whose posture was more closed, with her side to us, and turning away from him, although turning her head back, and as this gentleman said, there was a glint in her eye that said, maybe I'll listen. I don't know. Maybe we can have a conversation. I don't know. That's what I saw. I want to speak with you instead of at you. And I want to know, what are your thoughts about the sound of silence?
Silence can be protective.
Okay.
When you speak out, you make yourself vulnerable.
It's been around forever.
It has.
And it's Well, I haven't really gotten to think much about it until the last few years when I didn't have much else to think about. And it is aggravating. And you want to say to somebody, wait a minute, how about, you know, just another thought. But you don't always do that. And I don't know whether that stems from not feeling that you're important enough to say it and nobody's going to listen to you, or whether you're a woman and you were raised to be aggressive and speak and, you know.
Sometimes silence is assuming that someone else will do it, or
do it for you.
Possibly thinking, you know, maybe there's a leader somewhere that should do that and not me, you know, whether I'm not qualified or, but it's sort of the not wanting maybe to accept personal responsibility for some reason.
How do you feel about communication in general? Communication, speaking with one another as opposed to talking at one another, is beginning to be a lost art. We talk past one another. And we feel this, we get this feeling of anomy or not being heard.
I don't know, but when you do that, you identify yourself
as
whatever your beliefs are.
I think women, in just in general, have a long, long way to go when it comes to being respected for their opinions. You know, if women in particular, I think, say too much, and what is too much, I don't know, but voice an opinion with quite a bit of assertion and conviction, they're viewed entirely differently in the workplace, for example, than men. Granted, there may be some people who don't feel that way, but I think in general, the reputation that women get who decide that they are going to say what they truly think, it tends to take on negative tones, let's put it that way.